And another major breaking story from Ottawa this hour. An NDP MP is crossing the floor to join the Bloc Québécois. Quebec MP Claude Patry is defecting. Now, this is a serious blow to the opposition NDP. It's the third defection since the 2011 election. Leader Tom Mulcair says he's disappointed with Patry's decision. Our National Bureau Chief David Aiken joins us live in our Parliamentary Bureau with more details on the story. So David, why is Claude Patry crossing the floor? What reasons is he giving?
Well, at a press conference this morning in Ottawa, Patry said that he is upset with his party's position on the conditions through which Quebec might want to separate from the country. And he is also upset about a hydroelectric development in Newfoundland. That this has been a long-running issue, Quebec and Newfoundland, over hydroelectric development and the Churchill Falls project. There we go. So those are the two reasons that he gave. And Tom Mulcair, the leader of the NDP, came out very quickly afterwards and said, well, Mr. Patry, just a year and a bit ago, voted for an NDP motion, which essentially said, anytime there is a floor crossing in the House of Commons, that particular MP ought to quit and run in a by-election. In other words, allow the voters in that riding to pass their judgment on their decision. He challenged Mr. Patry to have the courage of his convictions resign, and Mulcair would boast that, you know, okay, great, we'll win that election. Jean-Pierre Alma is sort of central northern Quebec. It was held by the Conservatives prior to the NDP's election, and before that it's been a Bloc, and voters there have swung all over the place. They sort of en masse move one way or the other, but last time around about 47% voted for a new Democrat named Claude Patry, who now wants to sit as a Bloc. They're a Bloc MP. There's now going to be five Bloc Québécois MPs in the House of Commons. Still not enough that they are official party status, but they claim a moral victory today. And now the questions for the New Democrats, because the New Democrats, as you mentioned, have now lost three MPs, one from Northern Ontario, Bruce Heyer. He was initially kicked out by the previous leader, Nicole Turmel, because he voted to scrap the gun registry. And then when Mulcair took over, he sort of suggested Heyer could come back, and Heyer said, no, I'm staying as an independent. So that's one. And then shortly after last year, the 2011 election, another Quebec MP, Lise Saint-Denis, she quit the NDP caucus, said she didn't like these guys, didn't really know what she was getting into, and she went and joined the Liberal caucus. So that's three. Now, Patry clearly, though, he wants to join the folks who would take Quebec out of Canada. And I'll tell you what, the Prime Minister jumped on that immediately. He, as it turns out, was in Rivière-du-Loup, Quebec today. And at the end of a press conference there, he had this to say about why he thinks this is a troubling sign.
What happened in the House of Commons today with the crossing of the floor of a MP. This is an issue that has concerned us for some time, does concern us. The ambiguity on national unity, on Canadian unity, that we have among some members of the NDP caucus in Quebec. We know that that caucus has many, many links to Québec solidaire, which of course is a very strong sovereignist party at the provincial level. And this phenomenon of Bloc Orange, I think, should give everyone some considerable pause. And I think what has happened today is really another example of this particular problem.
Now, Snay, I want to draw your attention to a phrase the Prime Minister used there. He called them the Bloc Orange, in other words, suggesting that these new Democrats are really separatists in Federalist clothing, if you will. And this is a problem for Thomas Mulcair. Right now, the NDP are trying to get the House of Commons to vote on their, quote, Sherbrooke Declaration, which would say Quebec could begin negotiations to pull out of the country if 50% plus one voted on a clear question. Of course, everybody says, well, wait a minute, you can't even change the constitution of your own party without a two-thirds majority. How can you tear the country up with just 50% plus one? But a lot of people see Mulcair as adhering to that 50% plus one rule in order to appease the soft nationalists, that underlying sovereignist sympathizers that exist within the New Democratic Caucus. And you heard him talk about folks who have ties to Quebec Solidaire. We do know that some NDP MPs, as they're a Federalist party, gave money to Quebec Solidaire, which is even further sort of along the separatist spectrum. spectrum than the Bloc Québécois or Parti Québécois in the last provincial election cycle there. So Mulcair's got some political problems on his hands.
Yeah, he certainly does. And David, we do have that clip from Thomas Mulcair now. I just want to run his reaction this morning. This was just less than an hour ago, his reaction to this defection. Take a listen.
We call upon him to have the courage of those convictions, to step down from his seat in Jonquière Alma, and run in a by-election if he thinks that the people of his riding support him. He's talked about all the people he's consulted. He just keeps forgetting one thing. He hasn't consulted his electors on this. So the Sherbrooke Declaration is the position of our party. We're a proud Federalist party that works for a better life for Canadians from coast to coast to coast. And Mr. Patrie has said he's against floor crossing. That's the position that we want him to maintain.
So obviously Mulcair not happy. Is it possible though that we could see a by-election as a result of all this?
Well, I doubt it very highly. And that is a position the New Democrats have taken for a long time, that they believe if you're going to cross the floor, you ought to face your electors. Since Stephen Harper, just to give you the floor crossing history, since Stephen Harper became Prime Minister in 2006, we have seen six floor crossings. Three NDPers have left. Liberals have been the other ones that have left. David Emerson, most famously, within a week after the 2006 election, said, I don't want to be a Liberal, I'll join the Conservatives. Wajid Khan, he went to join the Conservatives. Another Liberal, a guy named Blair Wilson, he was about to get kicked out of the Liberal caucus, quit, and said he'd sit as a Green Party MP. And now we have these three new Democrats. Notably, no Bloc MP has crossed the floor, and no Conservative has crossed the floor since 2006.
Yeah, very interesting. Thank you, David.
Sure.
That is our National Bureau Chief David Aiken joining us live in our Parliamentary Bureau.